Yeah, alright. So today I want to talk about stopping the formation of an emotional attachment to a material item. Whether it's a book or something you knitted, these things. Today I'm throwing away an old hat and an old pair of slippers that I knitted, so it's part of the I'm not gonna be a hoarder ever. I'm trying to live that mantra and head in that trail immediately so I get rid of as much as possible. But it's so difficult, you know, because especially if you're like an artist, because you have to paint and you have to have the paints, the paintbrushes, and then this and that and the other, and so you end up, you know, with this all of this glug of item. And right now I'm in they're just in boxes. So when all of these things are just in boxes, I'm not using them. You see, so because they're not in use, they just end up as a materialistic hoarding event. So anyway, I had a bad day because I thought I shipped something online to someone, and I thought everything was swell, and then I find out later that, oh my gosh, I bought the most expensive shipping available, and I actually owe money, so it was a disaster. I owed like $3, and I was supposed to make money, so it became a disaster. Somehow it switched from regular to UPS, and I put a UPS label on, and I didn't even notice it. And then I put it at the post, so I don't know where it's gonna go now, because it went to the post office in their little box, and so now it's going with all of its expensive lights, saying this is a UPS. So, well, anyway, that was such a disaster book hoarding event that it cost $3 as well, and my time and energy to get it out there on this internet. So that's the type of, and I'm not emotionally attached to it at all, but I sure as heck don't want to pay extra for it. So, yeah, and then I'm like, well, I was reading about this hoarding, and they say that if you touch the item, I'm not kidding, this is what they're saying, if you touch the item more than once, it becomes like some special weird bond that you have with it. So the person who has this emotional hoarding attachment to items, they touch it again, oh my gosh, forget it, you can never get rid of it. It's just like something that you're just like, I mean, talk about fighting the uphill battle like forever, and you know, you can say all of these things, you know, and try to like be saleswoman of the year to get them out of it, but it does not happen. Something to do with the physical. Isn't that interesting? It's the physical touching, the actual of your own hands, touching that item, that bond has been created with just anything cruddy. I'm not kidding. It can be just anything cruddy. And that, whether an old magazine or a newspaper that you just got at the store, you know, it's a dangerous habit. And, you know, one of those that where it says, like, buy a house or something. You know, let's keep that, and keep another one, and keep another one. I touched it 3-4 times. Yeah, so, yeah. And then, so that's really the oddness. Is it, it's like a brain entrainment. And I'm like, well, what is it? Is it just like people are so desperate for love, you know? It's just love replacement, that item. Because, yeah, I mean, oh my gosh, I'm going to throw away a hat today, you know, I'm going to throw away my little slippers. You know, it's dramatic, you know, I spent a few hours, you know, knitting those, and I'm getting rid of them. but it's a step. It's a step so I don't become one of those. You know, so we're talking the world of minimal. And I'm like, well, and it's like with anything. And they were saying there are certain items that people are more prone to hoard, and books are one of them, which was odd. I thought, well, look, I would think, well, what's the big deal with a book? I mean, it's just like, what's the emotional attachment there? But it's all of that touching moment when you're there and you even opened it up or you even purchased it and you put it on the shelf. That's twice that you touch that item. So you don't even really have to ever even open the book, but you've got some strange bond with it. It's very, very odd, because when you look at how many books are out there, I mean, there's just millions, and how could you have an attachment to that one type, you know, just because you touched it? It's very strange. So it's a strange, like a personal phenomenon, a psychological battle. You know, it's a personal event, you know. And it's allowed by, I mean, it's just terribly allowed. I mean, it should be illegal, but it's allowed to, that we can just keep collecting and collecting and collecting and collecting. And then they say, oh, well, at the end, you just give it off to Goodwill or whatever. It's just allowed. And it should not be so, because in those years of collecting and collecting and collecting, you know, somebody else could use it. You know, somebody else, you know. I just feel like it's a loss. It's just a loss, a waste. And when you have all these people with all of these items and all of their boxes, and they're hoarded here or they're hoarded there, it creates more demand for the item for the person who wanted it. They can't have it because it's hidden away in a box, or they can't have it because it's hidden away on your shelf somewhere that you don't even want to look at. They just can't have it. And so the hoarders create another consumer mecca event that didn't have to happen. I mean, we don't have to go and reprint that book. You know, we should never have to go and reprint that book again. And, you know, instead of having it in 30, 40 households in a box somewhere nobody wants, you know, instead it's going off to getting printed again, you know. So this is like, what is it? It's just like the true selfishness state. I believe it is. I believe it's the true selfishness state. At first I'm like, what a greedy thing, you know, that you want to keep all of this crud that you've acquired. You know, I even say to myself, you know, what a greedy thing, you know, it's just an old shirt, get rid of it, you know. It's something that you just wore to, you know, paint a room. You don't need it, get rid of it, you know. You have too many of those types of pants. So then I'm like, well, it's back to something else, isn't it? It's back to There is a connection there. There is an overdone love connection in the brain. Now, does that mean that we are vying for love? We don't have enough love. We need more. We need more. So we're using these as our replacers. Well, that makes a very greedy, selfish person, because that makes more out at the factory. You know, more out at the publishers. More that has to be created, you know, just because, you know, we have to look for a way to fill that void. I don't know. That's the wrong way to fill the void.
Did you want to feed the dogs today?
Anyway, ciao.
Huh?